This video is sponsored by Oculus. Okay, so that's my version of an unboxing drum roll. Hey, what's up guys? Soldier knows best here. So look, I'm a huge fan of VR. I play VR every single week and I'm a huge fan of the original Oculus Quest, and I always have it sitting here by my desk when I want to kind of escape for a little while. But anyway, when Oculus reached out and they wanted to sponsor this video for me to give you my unboxing and my first impressions of this new Quest 2, I couldn't resist it. So let's get inside this unboxing and get things started right away. All right, so let's slide this out of here. And now let's get our first look at what comes with this bad boy here, and boom, there we go. So we have everything that you will get if you do pick one of these up for yourself. And let's first start with the box right here. All right, so it looks like we do have some paperwork, instruction manual, all that stuff, but we know what we're doing here. We don't need to have that stuff. But we do have the wall adapter here. This is USB-C, and then you also do get a USB-C cable to go along with that. And then next, we do have a spacer for your eyeglasses. If I can pull this out, there we go. I'm about to break it already. But yeah, so this will allow you to be able to wear your specs while you are playing your VR games and stuff. And so that just adds just enough space so your glasses aren't gonna be touching like the lens and stuff like that. So yeah, always good to have this. And now let me just get everything else outside of the box here and place this thing to the side. Okay, so first impressions, I'm liking this gray slash white color here. I think it's gonna definitely hold up better as far as like scratches and things like that. And then also too, Oculus says that this is going to be 10% lighter than the original Quest, and I can definitely feel that difference. And so let me get a closer look here with the original Quest. And yeah, side by side, I can definitely feel the weight difference between the two. And then also too, this Quest 2 is going to be smaller than the original one as well. So all of these things are gonna hopefully make for just a better, more comfortable experience when you are wearing this, especially for long periods of time. And some other things that I'm noticing here is that they moved the power button from right here over to here directly on the side now. And then also too, on the other side, you will find that the USB-C port has moved from right here over here. And then also you will only find one headphone port on this Quest 2 versus the two that was on the original Quest. And on the front, you'll notice these four sensors, and these work with the Guardian system, and that also works with the Pass-Through Plus system. And so this basically means that you create your own kind of Guardian when you start playing with the Oculus Quest headset. So while you're in the headset, if you do come up close to that boundary, it would actually activate the Pass-Through Plus, and now you'll be able to see your environment around you. And so yeah, basically it's your guardian angel to keep you from tripping over things. And so this works when you are standing, and also too, it works in a seated position as well. So you have a couple of different options to use that with. And this Quest 2 does have built-in IPD adjustment, so basically you can push the lenses away from each other or you can push them closer to each other, and it looks like you have three different kind of sections there to adjust to. And your IPD is basically the distance between your eyes, and that's going to be different for a lot of people, so just finding that right adjustment will allow everything to remain clear and crisp when you are viewing things in VR. Now this does feel like a different type of phone from the original Quest, and I'll let you know in a second once I get this on my face how it feels. But there is also a new strap adjustment system here, so these straps feel a little bit more kind of durable. But then also too, you can move these to the left and to the right, and this will allow you to be able to get that good fit on your head. And on the top, you do have some Velcro here, and this will allow you to kind of slide this out, and this will better adjust for the size of your head. And because my head is kind of big, I'm gonna keep going to about right there. But now for the ultimate test, let me see how this thing fits on my head. So let me get this thing going and see how well of a job I did as far as the adjustment. And I have to say I did pretty good. So you do wanna make sure this is resting on the back of your head, so you wanna make sure it kind of cups it. And then also too, I feel like this strap here at the top, I can actually tighten this up a little bit. And right there is good. So because this Quest 2 is a self-contained unit, so everything is on the inside here. So all of the components, including the 6 gigabytes of RAM, the new Qualcomm Snapdragon XR2 platform inside of here, all of that stuff is right here in the front. So making sure these straps are well tightened and actually fit properly is important because everything's gonna be kind of front heavy. But yeah, I'm definitely going to need more time to really put this through its paces to really see how it feels, but I think it's off to a really good start. And then also too, this facial interface right here, you can actually just pop this out if you wanted to. So if you need to kind of exchange it, you can do that. that. And Oculus will be selling a fit pack, which will include two interchangeable facial interfaces. One's gonna be a little bit wider, one's gonna be a little bit narrower, and that will help you get a really good fit and feel on your face. And you can also take off these straps and replace them with one of their elite straps, which will be not only more comfortable, but they also will be selling an elite strap which has a built-in battery inside of it, so you can stay in VR a lot longer. But all right, let me take a break with the headset for a second and just take a look at these controllers. All right, so the first thing I wanna show you with the controllers is the new redesigned battery compartment here. So with the original Quest, the controllers had a magnetic attachment for the battery cover, and that could sometimes come off when you are playing VR and doing things like boxing and stuff. If you're being a little rough, it could have accidentally slid off. But this time they made it really tough. So you see here, it takes a little bit more effort, but that's because it has kind of this little clip right inside of here, and that goes in this particular slot right there. And so now this is going to be way more secure, and the odds of this coming off when you are playing VR are going to be a lot slimmer. And these also do have wrist straps, and I definitely recommend to keep these on while you're in VR, just in case you get a little too excited. You don't want the controllers to become loose, and you just put these on your wrists. They don't take that much time at all. Tighten them down a little bit, and then now you are going to be ready to go. Now, one thing about these controllers too is that the surface area, just the overall size of them, definitely are bigger than the previous Quest controllers. And I actually don't mind it at all. They don't actually feel heavier, but they just feel like they have more of a surface area, especially right here for your thumb. So you have some places here where you can rest your thumb. And let me get one of the original controllers here. Okay, so I can definitely see a difference between the two. You can just look at the difference in ring size, and then also you can see that surface area here. And then also the triggers on the new controllers are definitely bigger and wider, which I like. But right now I'm about to get this thing set up so I can take a look at some of the visual enhancements that you get from the extra power and performance out of this thing. So let me get to it. All right, so I got the headset set up here. I got the controller strapped to my wrist. Let's get into it. So one of the first thing I noticed when I was setting this up was that the ghosting is a lot better on this headset. And ghosting happens when you have like white text on like a dark background. Sometimes it has like a glowing effect to it. That definitely is not as relevant on this particular headset. And let me open up my Oculus home menu here and let me go to Real VR Fishing first. And so one of the things about this headset is that you do have those 50% better pixels in it. And also, it will be able to run certain content at 90 hertz as well. So that's going to be that 90 hertz refresh rate that will make things feel a little bit smoother and a little bit faster as well. Let me go here first. So it's been a while since I played this game, but Real VR Fishing has always had really good visuals, but they've updated this app to take advantage of the Quest 2. And boom, look at that. And so these are definitely a better pair of gloves I've ever owned. And just looking at the detail, man, look at the rocks. Look at the reflection, the waves, the detail with the city background. I mean, this game has always been dope, but it definitely looks better. And so let me see if I can actually catch a fish. It's been a while here, so let me throw it. Oh, sunglasses on, and boom. All right. Oh, wow, look at that rainbow. I didn't see that before. Almost. Come to papa. And gotcha. All right, so yeah, they've also, man, look at this fish, man. You can see all the individual scales here, and you can get really close up to it, and you still have that really good quality. Look at that. Let me go into Arizona sunshine here. So yeah, it's looking good. Look at the clothes. Don't move. Don't move. Don't be scared. Come here. Come here, little buddy. Oh, you're another soldier too. I'm sorry. Oh, missed those first ones. Man, my aim is off. That wasn't. And now I'm in Waltz of the Wizard, another app that has been updated to work with the Quest 2 and to be able to, you know, take advantage of that power. And yeah, I can see it. I can see the magic in what they're doing here. So definitely have just that extra level of clarity. And let me see if I can make a potion real quick. Throw that in there, and I think it should be good. And oh, make sure you wash your hands before you play VR. I'm joking, you don't have to do that. All right, pistol whip time. Let me get my John Wick on. And there you go, boom. One shot. Oh, I did not stretch. Oh man, I should have stretched before I played this game. Yeah, soldier's getting old. Oh. All right. Well, you can see I have a little bit of work to do, but anyway, guys, I'm gonna stop this video right here. And so look, with this Quest 2, I think the best part about this is the price starting at $299. It's a very good entry level price. If you're thinking about getting into VR, maybe you haven't tried it yet and you want to. And look, I'm excited for the next gen systems, and I have the Xbox Series X over there and I've been playing it and it's great. But VR is something totally different, and you can not only just game, but also too, you can link up with your friends and go into an app like Big Screen VR, and now you can watch a movie in a movie theater, or you can watch sporting events and concerts. And yeah, another thanks to Oculus for sponsoring this video. And also too, what do you think about VR? What do you think about this headset? Leave your comment down below. But like always, I do want to thank you for watching this video, and I will catch you later. Peace. The little straps came in hand. Peace.